Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the session 8 of Java and Web, Modular Programming in Java. In this video, we will create our first module in Java. I want to create my first module on the desktop. So let's go to the desktop. Here I am showing the Linux directory structure, but the same thing is applicable on Windows. If you consider this directory structure as C drive, users, Gyan, desktop. I am using here Linux directory structure, but you can apply the same thing on the Windows directory structure. Now on the desktop, I need to create two directories, one for the source code of module, I will call that directory as src, other for the compiled classes of the module, I will call that directory as out. We need to create the directory src manually on the desktop, and the directory out will be created automatically when we compile our module. Now decide the module name. The name I decided is my module. Create a directory with name same as your module name. I call it my module. Inside the directory src, create a directory with name my module. The directory my module is now source directory of my module. So on the desktop, I am creating the source directory of my module. And inside the directory src, I started to create my module. And the first thing I did, I created a directory with name my module. The information about the module, my module, is provided in a Java file called moduleinfo.java. The moduleinfo.java is a special name. This name cannot be different. Create moduleinfo.java in the directory my module. All the information about the module, my module, will be stored into the Java file moduleinfo.java. And that moduleinfo.java will be directly created in the module directory. This is the minimum code in moduleinfo.java. We need to write the keyword module space the module name. In my case, the module name is my module. So module space module name followed by the opening curly bracket, and we have to write something in between these two curly bracket, and then after the closing curly bracket. In this example, we do not need to write anything in between these two curly brackets. This is the minimum code of moduleinfo.java. We will see more about moduleinfo.java in the coming videos of this session. Let's check it practically. On the desktop, I have created a directory with name src. Inside the directory src, we have another directory my module. Inside the directory my module, we have the moduleinfo.java. Let's open moduleinfo.java. And this is the moduleinfo.java. Module space the module name. In my case, it is my module. And then opening and closing curly brackets. Now we need to create a Java file with main method. And this is our Java file with main method, main.java. The main.java has a package statement, package mypack. So the class file created because of compilation of main.java will be stored into a directory mypack. We have created the directory named mypack and created the file main.java in it. We can directly create the main.java in the directory mymodule. Since main.java contains the package statement mypack, so if we create main.java directly in the my module, then after compilation the directory mypack will be created in the compiled module. But it is a good coding practice to write main.java in the directory mypack. Now let's check the directory structure practically. Here we have the src directory. Inside the src directory, we have my module directory. Inside the my module directory, we have moduleinfo.java and we have another directory mypack. Inside the mypack, we have the Java file main.java. Let's open it. This is the main.java. We have package statement package mypack. We have the class whose name is main. Inside the class main, we have the method main, which is printing my first module. So we already have created the source directory src of our module inside the directory desktop. Now let's execute the source code. Go to the terminal and make your current directory as desktop. Let's open terminal and go to the desktop, cd desktop. We have the directory src on the desktop. We first need to compile our module, so execute javac command. But at this time we need to execute javac command with different options. We need to write javac dash dash module source path src. We need to provide the full or relative path name of the source code of our module. Here I am using relative path name of our directory which contains the source code of our module. But we can also use here /home/yarn/desktop/src instead of just writing src. Since our current directory is desktop, so we can directly write here src, because the directory src is the direct child of the desktop. Then we have to use option D, write -d. The D option specifies the relative or full path name of the directory where we need to store our compiled module. Then after, we need to provide the relative or full path name of two Java files we have. First, we are providing the relative path name of the Java file module-info.java. Then we are providing the relative path name of the Java file main.java. When we execute the command javac, a directory whose name is out gets created containing the class files corresponding to the Java files present in the src directory. So a directory whose name is out gets created on the desktop. The directory out contains the same directory structure which the directory src had. Inside the directory out, we have another directory mymodule which contains module-info.class and contains another directory which is a package directory mypack. Inside the package directory mypack, we have another class main.class. So all the Java files in the directory src has been converted into the class file in the directory out. So we are done with the compilation of our first module in Java. Let us try it practically. Our current directory is on the desktop, which contains the directory src. Being on the desktop directory as the current directory, execute the following command: javac --module-source-path. Then write here your module source path, which is the directory src. We have just created all the source codes corresponding to our module in the directory src. Write here src space -d. And write here the name of the directory where you want to store your compiled module. Type here out. Then after, provide the relative or full path name of the Java files stored in your module. I want to use here the relative path name. Write here src mymodule module-info.java space. We have another Java file main.java. Name that Java file src mymodule mypack main.java. Press enter. And your module has been compiled fine. And you can see here you have another directory out created in the current directory. This is the directory out created in the current directory. If I go on the desktop, then you can see we have another directory out. Inside the directory out, we have my module directory. Inside the my module directory, we have the class file module-info.class and another directory mypack. Go in the directory mypack, we have another class file main.class. We can use here full path names of various directories and various Java files. Let me use full path names here. javac --module-source-path. And instead of src, write here home-yarn-desktop-src. And instead of out, write here home-yarn-desktop-out. We can create the out directory somewhere else on the file system. Then write here home-yarn-desktop-src-module-module-info.java. Write here home-yarn-desktop-src-module-mypack-main.java. Press enter. It is still working fine and doing the same as it did before. Let's go in the directory src, go in the directory mymodule, then in the directory mypack, open main.java. This is the Java file which contains the package statement package mypack. That's how we have stored main.java in the directory mypack. Now I want to shift the main.java in the directory mymodule instead of mypack. Let's shift it. Cut from the mypack and paste it in the mymodule. Now delete the directory mypack. Shift delete. since the main.java contains the package statement mypack, so the directory mypack will be automatically created in the directory my module of the directory out. Let me try to compile this code again. We need to execute this code, but with some change. Our main.java is not in the directory mypack. It's in the directory my module. Press enter. It compiles fine. And it created the directory structure out similar to previous one. But this is not a good way of code management. We should not store the Java file main.java in the directory my module. We are done with the compilation of our first module and we are all set to run our first module. To run the module, we need to execute the Java command with various different options. We need to write the command java followed by dash dash module path. Followed by module path, we need to write full path name or relative path name of a directory where we have stored our compiled module. We have stored our compiled module in the directory out. Followed by add modules, we need to provide the name of the module which we want to execute. We want to execute the module my module. Followed by name of the module, we have fully qualified name of the class which we want to execute. So we need to write mypack.main. The command executes and it prints first module. Let's execute this command practically. Type java space dash dash module dash path space out space dash dash add dash modules space my module space mypack dot main. Press enter. It runs fine and printing my first module. Here in this slide I have written first module, but actually I executed a code which was printing my first module. That's how our code prints my first module. These are some more commands to compile and run modules. First one is java c dash dash module source path src dash d out dash m my module. Here rest of the command is fine. The only new option is minus m. Minus m followed by the module name. This is another way to execute java c command. Let me try this. Java c module source path src d out. Then after I need to write here m followed by the name of the module, my module. Remove the Java file names. If you are using the M option, you should not write here name of the Java files. So remove name of the Java files. Press enter. It compiles fine. Instead of dash M, we can write here dash dash module. So let me try this one. Java C module source path dash dash module followed by name of the module. Press enter. It again compiles fine. We already have used the third Java C command. Now let's try various Java commands. We already have used the third one. Let's use the first one. Java dash dash module path out. Then after we need to write dash m followed by name of the module forward slash fully qualified name of the class containing method main. Let us try this command. Write here minus m my module forward slash mypack dot main. Press enter. It runs fine. Instead of using minus m, we can use double dash module. Type here double dash module. Press enter. It also executes fine. We already have executed the Java command in third way. Inside a module, we cannot create a class without package. Let us try to create a class without package in a module. Let us do one more experiment. Go to src directory, my module, and open main.java. comment out the package statement mypack. Now let's compile this module. I am about to compile this module. Press enter. At this time the compiler throws an error. src my module main.java unnamed package is not allowed in named modules. So inside a module we cannot create a class without package statement. Best way to create a module is create separate files for each classes. Each class should belong to a package. That's all for this video guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe this channel if you are new and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.